Good afternoon, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank all of you for being here. My special thanks goes to Arvi and his parents, her parents, to be here this evening. As he shared that today we want to talk about a case which is rare, complex, and it's a life-saving surgery, which is performed by Dr. Amitabh Chanda, who's there with me today, Dr. Sucharita, Dr. Agni Shekhar, and Dr. Sudipto Bhattacharya, who's an associate consultant with us. So it's a teamwork which has been done on the small baby, who was, when operated upon, was 4 months old. Now she's close to 9 to 10 months. And I would request Dr. Chanda to take you through the case.
Rare congenital conditions, inborn error. Plus, we see these kind of patients, but not of this size. The lesion which was there, we hardly see lesions of this size. But before I start, I want to acknowledge a few persons of my teammates who were there. Dr. Sucharita Chakraborty, anesthesiologist. And I want to thank her because it's a challenge to give anesthesia to a 4-month-old baby. So I thank her. Our pediatrician, Dr. Abhishek Sahab, was there. He was of immense help to take care of the medical needs of the child. My co-worker, my colleague, Dr. Sudipto Bhattacharya, another neurosurgeon. Dr. Parthapatim Gupta, one of our associates. Dr. Tibar Bandhapadhyay was another plastic surgeon who worked with us for some period of time. And last but not the least, our zonal director, Mrs. Richa Dev Gupta. Now, this child was born on 4th October 2013 with a big swelling in the back, and that was progressively growing. And when she came to us, she was about 1.5 months old. So this was, in fact, this was the picture taken during operation. We wanted to wait a little because we wanted the child to be a little larger in size. We wanted the vaccination to be completed and then only went ahead for operation. And there are some other logistic issues for which we had to wait till the child was about 3 to 4 months old. She was 3.5 months when she was operated, right? 17th January, if I am not mistaken. So, what is the problem? This was a big swelling, and when we got an MR done, we saw the spinal cord was herniating. This is a big sac. This is the spine, the bony spine, and this black grayish thing is the spinal cord. This is herniated into the sac, and with several strands, it was attached to the wall of the sac. The whole swelling contained part of the spinal cord, which is herniated into the sac. What is the problem? If we do not do anything for this child, what would have happened? First, this is a very ugly looking, grotesque looking swelling, and it is a mechanical disadvantage to carry the child with this kind of swelling. That's the difference, that anybody can say that with this kind of swelling it is not feasible, you can't carry the child like that. Second thing, if this gets injured, there will be leakage of the cerebrospinal fluid, the fluid which circulates around the brain and spinal cord. If that leaks, there is high chance of meningitis, and meningitis can kill the child. Number three problem, we know the spinal cord along with its strands are attached to the sac. Our spine grows in size as we grow taller and older. The spinal cord also grows in size, but not as much as the spine, bony spine. So, what happens in us, when we grow taller, the spine becomes larger, the spinal cord also grows, but not as much as the spine. What happens? The lower end of the spinal cord actually moves up in the spinal cord. So if the spinal cord, lower limit of the spinal cord at birth was here, when we grow old, the spinal cord ends here. Because the spinal cord didn't grow as much as the spine, bony spine grew. But here what will happen? Since the spine is tethered here, the spinal cord will be stretched. Because the spinal cord won't be able to move up. freely. So it will be stretched, and gradually the child would have lost power in the lower limbs. She would have become paralytic, or lost the control of urine and stool. What is the prolongation of the neural tissue, nerve tissue? If we make a section, transverse section to the spine and spinal cord, we'll have a picture like this. This is the front, this is the back, these are the two sides. This is the spinal cord in the spine, and the nerve roots comes out through there, and this is covered by skin and bone and everything. What happens in myelomeningocele, if there is a skin or not, the spinal cord herniates.
This is the one.
Thank you.